Good morning, everybody. How are we today? Hope everybody's well out there. Everyone holding up all right now? So it's the weekend. Hope everybody's having a good time at home and everything like that. Before we start today, I want to just remind everyone, on Monday, we've got a special talk by Maxwell Hahn. He's taking us off the grid, diving in rivers and ponds and more kind of crazy, unexpected places to show us the amazing stuff he finds out there in the wild of British Columbia. This weekend, too, we're also going to be releasing week 4 of Ocean Stories. So that'll be coming out. Look for it on social media and dive into his Facebook and Instagram and all that stuff. And let me launch the poll and get Sarah, if you're there, can you turn on your video and mic for me?
Yeah.
There you are. Good morning, Sarah. How are you?
Good afternoon or evening, actually.
Oh, yeah. Evening for you guys. All right. So the poll is launched. So today we've got Sarah joining us. Sarah has created one of the biggest forces in scuba diving communities, I think, on Earth right now. She's the founder of Girls That Scuba, and they do a lot of work in the industry and a lot of really cool stuff in the female community and just, you know, building lots of amazing stuff. So how are we doing today, Sarah?
Really good. It's very sunny in England. It's Easter weekend. And yeah, feeling good. Excited to talk to everybody.
Awesome. Well, let me stop my screen share right now and let you put yours up and we'll get started.
All right. Let me do that. share screen. All right. But
perfect.
Cool.
So over to you.
All right. Can you see me okay? Can't see myself.
Yeah, we can see you fine. Everything is
all right, cool. That's fine. I can't see myself, but that works. That works better, actually. All right, guys. So, hello, everyone that's joining us. This is a very surreal experience, I have to admit. I'm effectively just talking to a laptop here and can't see myself and I can't see you. So, hopefully everyone's there. And, you know, you're going to enjoy what I've got in store for you today. So for those of you that don't know me and don't know Girls at Scuba, my name is Sarah Richard and I am the founder of Girls at Scuba. Girls at Scuba is the world's largest scuba dive community. I'm just gonna see if I can also see myself here as well to make it a little bit easier. Nope. All right. So Girls at Scuba is the world's largest female scuba dive community. We started up just 3 years ago. So we're still very, very new in this industry. And it was started by myself when I realized there was quite a gap in the market for kind of promoting and empowering females, mainly because what I could see that there wasn't actually that many females around in diving. Of course there was, but we just didn't really have a way to kind of like all connect together in a platform. So I kind of went around thinking about, like, you know, how can we raise profiles of women in scuba diving? And, you know, that day and age, I say that day and age, this day and age, it was only 3 years ago. It's all about social media. So I went onto Facebook and kind of thought, well, I'm sure I can find one myself, find a community rather than create my own. But I couldn't find one. So I decided that it was time that I would just create my own, and Girls at Scuba was created. So that was 3 years ago. Now we are looking at a community, a network of over 700,000 divers. That's men and women. A lot of our groups are just privately just for women, but obviously the social medias that we have are for men as well. And in the Girls at Scuba is actually Girls at Scuba Network, because we have Girls at Freedive, Girls at Tech Dive, and loads of other kind of groups that go with it. But we're not here to really talk too much about Girls at Scuba. I want to talk more about females in industry, and just quickly about myself. Before I was doing all of this, I was a travel blogger and I was traveling the world, scuba diving, going to amazing destinations, writing all about it, doing it on social media, which is where kind of my experience came for then to launch Girls at Scuba. And yeah, just love a bit of coffee and also just completely obsessed with like being plastic free and trying to kind of make a better impact on this world. So let's talk about what we're here for. Is scuba diving still a male sport? This is definitely going to be opinionated, hopefully open up debate and conversation, because what you guys are hearing is just kind of like my kind of like opinions on it and what I've kind of felt while developing Girls at Scuba over the last few years. So before I begin, there is going to be some sexual referencing, there is going to be some sexual photos, so just kind of like trigger warning to begin with that we will be speaking a little bit about kind of sexuality, not sexuality, about kind of like sexual imagery and stuff like that. Also, I want you to keep an open mind. I want you to follow along and wait until afterwards that we can kind of all talk about it together. Maybe something that you're thinking or feeling I may cover on later in the slideshow. So just keep an open mind. And also, what I'm covering about females in the dive industry is quite heavily to do with the media, so what the media portray, because I've found like over the years that a lot of people will say like, oh, there's loads of female scuba divers where I dive in Bonaire or where I dive in Indonesia, and there are so many destinations where there are lots of female divers, but there's also some that have none at all. So when we're talking about like how is the female perceived, what I'm talking about today is more within the media, within mainstream media, within like magazines, TV and film. Just so if you are thinking like, oh well, where I am there is loads and loads of females, maybe just also take that time to realize that not everywhere there is. So yes, let's start. Right, so I'm not going to talk to you about the history of scuba diving. Hopefully you already know that. If not, you can definitely take a look after this. But we all know Jacques Cousteau, and that was kind of the beginning of recreational scuba diving, which is what we're talking about now. In that was around 1942. So obviously he's a male, cool. First female scuba diver was actually his first wife, so Simone Cousteau. She was scuba diver at Aquanaut, and she actually played a really, really big part in all of Jacques Cousteau's kind of like films and kind of everything that we kind of know about him now. She almost played like quite a behind the scenes role, because she was never actually visible in the documentary series that Jacques Cousteau did, The Undersea World of Jacques Cousteau. She played a key role in the operations at sea, acting as a mother, healer, nurse and psychiatrist for the all-male crew for 40 years. I don't know about you guys, but I have never known that much about her. And it's been really great reading about her. And, you know, I know that he was the forefront and he was the one that kind of took the limelight, but it's a shame because she sounds super, super cool. So maybe we can do more on her in Girls at Scuba. So I'm going to kind of go away from the history and kind of talk more towards kind of like the last kind of century. So lots of amazing things happened between the 1940s and the 1980s. Lots of amazing things happened before the 1940s as well, but really within recreational scuba diving. The 40s to the 80s, you know, great female role models came about, like Valerie Taylor, Sylvia Earle. You know, they all stepped into the spotlight as kind of those first famous scuba divers and activists, and that we all still know and love today. So there always has been, you know, spotlight on females in scuba diving. But now we're going to talk about kind of what has kind of been portrayed as being a female in the scuba industry. So you can see on your screen now some interesting images, I would say. So these were found on the depth of the internet, but they actually came to my attention with in the Girls at Scuba Facebook group. Somebody posted and she put, "Thank God so much has changed. So what we can see here is scuba aquacene. So what I found out was very little information about it, but it was a UK actually diving magazine in the 80s. So you can actually see there on the date, it's January 1983. And we've got a picture of three women, like pretty much naked. I mean, you've got nipples out there. If this was on social media, I'm sure it'd be taken down now. So it's just very, when I first saw them, it was like interesting and shocking that, like, once upon a time, females used to be sexualized like this, but kind of in the scuba dive industry scene. So this is kind of the first imagery I could really find that was media based. So that obviously the women have given consent for these photos, hopefully, to actually be put on the magazines. And then these are just some extra, some more that I found. This one on the left with her nipples. This was a film. It was called The Deep. I'm not sure, I can't remember what it's called now, but I watched the trailer and I'm never going to get those 10 minutes back of my life. It was about star-crossed lovers who went on holiday and managed to go scuba diving, but then got caught in an accident. She, of course, got eaten by a shark or attacked by a shark, but a lot of the imagery is her with her nipples and her boobs out. And the middle one is like a similar, and the right one again is I think that might even be the similar in the same movie as the first one. This is another very interesting one that I found. Can't say I know that brand. I don't know if any of you guys do. But it is obviously advertising cylinders and tanks. And obviously the way that they chose to advertise tanks then was with naked girls. The actual description doesn't really say anything other than, you know, just kind of promoting their product. Looks like almost a half page spread or even a full page spread, again in an English dive magazine. So very interesting to take a look at those kind of 80s, even late 70s, kind of the way that women started to become sexualized in scuba diving as like a sex object that could go alongside of men or kind of bring men into scuba diving with these beautiful girls trying to advertise their products. So yeah, so that was like the 70s, the 80s. We're now going to go on to the 90s. So the 90s and the 2000s, kind of when the internet started, was when scuba fetishes came around. I mean, they might have been around way, way before that, but it's when it kind of became into the internet and scuba porn. Now, I have to tell you guys, like, researching for this presentation, if, you know, anyone ever looks at my laptop, there's going to be some funny search history, because I really had to kind of try and understand where scuba fetish came from, where scuba porn came from, and where it kind of lies today. And from what I found out is that men find like very tight wetsuits very sexy, but mainly having something in the mouth, which is like the regulator, which actually is what they feel like is choking the woman. So it's just so degrading and it's terrible to read and look up. So I'd never advise anybody doing too much more research into it, but these were kind of some of the photos that I found online. And as you can see, as scuba divers, we can tell they're not actually scuba divers. So what they are is, you know, maybe models or porn actresses who are actually dressing up to look like scuba divers. But you have to think about what that kind of, you know, how that makes people think of female scuba divers in the 90s and the early 2000s. If that was one of the only imageries that you've ever seen of female scuba divers, you wouldn't take them seriously. So I also, because I wanted to be very fair in this process, and I wanted to see if women also were into scuba fetishes and if women also sexualized men in scuba diving equipment, and this is what I found. I'm not joking. I typed in like scuba fetish men or sexy the male scuba divers or something like that, to kind of just to see, do some research if it was also women that were interested in men in scuba diving, and this is what I found. So I think that's a clear no, maybe not. So then let's start talking about 2010, so kind of the later, well, the earlier, but later 2000s, where magazine media started playing more of a kind of pivotal role in like the scuba diving media that we know today. So I actually found lots of really positive front covers as well, something that I didn't see the point in doing, but did also see in my research. There was a lot of male front covers, especially males in like rebreathers or males in just kind of like every single piece of equipment they can get, looking very, very solemn and never ever smiling. But the female ones that I found were quite positive. You know, there wasn't so much of that like sexualization. There wasn't so many kind of bikini shots and very, very tight wetsuits or anything that's kind of like a scuba fetish. So those were some of the three that I found, which I think actually they could be shared today, and you wouldn't have known. You know, they're very up to date of what we know at the moment. And then I'm kind of coming on to where we are around about now, and just before we got into 2020, where maybe most of us have been more aware of social media, and most of us have been more aware of females in the industry. So it was kind of like, oh, is this the rise of the positive imagery and females? I mean, you can see two very great covers there. These two are actually both a magazine in the UK, celebrating women and diving, not putting like just perfect pictures up, you know, females that obviously have been diving or doing cave activities. So that was really great to see. But what I also found was that in film, that didn't actually really change. And, you know, in this the mainstream media of film and TV, the female scuba diver may not be so much of an obvious sexual object, but she was almost a dumb kind of like character who didn't have any clue about scuba diving. So for anyone that's seen this terrible film, will kind of know that the two girls, one of them didn't even never even scuba dive before, and then of course the shark was coming to bite them. So not only was it showing negative imagery and negative kind of emotions and thoughts about sharks, it was also showing the women as very kind of dumb women who put themselves in that problem, like it was kind of their fault because they didn't really know what they were doing. And then I was kind of also thinking about stepping away from like that media, and how about behind closed doors, you know, in this 2010, 2020 era, like behind closed door, were women still being sexualized in the industry? So that's kind of like the me and you, like women, are we still being sexualized rather than someone that might be on the front cover of a scuba diving magazine or on a movie? And in 2018, the Me Too movement kind of really came about, 2019, and actually ourselves at Girls at Scuba released kind of some quotes from members who have experienced sexual harassment or sexual abuse in the industry. And it's a very poignant, hard-hitting article, which, you know, we still talk about a lot now when anyone asks us why we need a female dive community. So if you haven't already read that, I would encourage you to read it, just to become more aware of you know, what is happening behind the scenes. And then so that's the article on the left with the picture of the lady. On the right, there was something that I found on Reddit around, I think, late 2018-19, and it was a woman saying, I faced quite a few issues as a female diver in the community over the last couple of years. I've turned it around now, but there have been many times when it's not been great. Having said that, there are loads more who have never treated me differently because I'm female. And somebody replied, care to elaborate on those issues? The only different treatment I see female divers getting is a ton of offers to carry their dive gear for them. So that's just one of the examples that is actually in the article, that kind of shows that behind the scenes, while maybe like there was more positive imagery being shown to female scuba divers or female scuba divers, it maybe still wasn't actually changing that much behind the scenes. So now we're on to today, 2020, where I actually, this was literally about an hour ago, wanted to type in like female scuba divers into all the major search engines to see what I found. So as you can see here, positive imagery, great, like perfect, all girls scuba diving. I know that, I think that one's me. There's some, they're the Paddy ambassadors. You've got women in diving in 2018. But the thing that kind of struck me was the things that I've circled. So these are like key words. So when you do type in something to Google, or any other search engine, they will also bring up keywords that other people have searched alongside of that. So as you can see, it's beautiful and cute. And it's like, okay, so maybe people are typing in like beautiful scuba divers or cute scuba divers. And then I also went on to Bing. And that one showed, So that one showed not similar images, but then there were still some of those kind of scuba fetish, very, very tight lycra images, but again, not as bad as those ones that we'd seen in the 80s and the 90s. So these are the first top pages on the search engine. So the ones that everyone would see straight away. Again, it was those key words that were coming up, and this one, you know, was a little bit kind of disturbing. Young women scuba, single women scuba divers, pregnant scuba divers, pretty women scuba diving, beautiful female scuba divers. So what that means is that alongside female scuba divers, other people have been searching for those terms. So today in, you know, literally today in 2020, it does seem like the imagery is a lot more positive, but it's almost like, again, one step behind, there maybe is still some kind of like sexualizing and maybe not taking women as seriously as they deserve to be. So a few of you might be thinking, you know, well, what about today? What about sharing on social media women in bikinis and everything like that? And, you know, what I'm showing you here is our Girls at Scuba, some screenshots from our Girls at Scuba Instagram to show you that we do have women in bikinis. We do have women of all shapes, sizes, and from all over the world. But we're not scared of showing people in bikinis, and then there's reasons for that as well. But, you know, coming to 2020, where women now have more control over what they put up online, and actually more of an understanding that if they do put stuff up online, then it almost is open for the internet. But I mean, is it still a safe place as a female scuba diver to upload a picture of you in a wetsuit or a bikini, even though that's something that we have to wear to actually go scuba diving? So I actually did some research and I found some awful things really that still exist today. So the first one, which is in the right hand side, is a private group called Women in Scuba Gear, which I have actually known about for a little while, and I've reported numerous times, but it doesn't get taken down. I actually got sent a screenshot of one of the posts in there, and it was a woman with like with her bum out, but she didn't have her bum out. She was just wearing a bikini like any of us would on the boat in between dives, and it was being posted in this group. And it was men that was commenting on it. I mean, I can't say, I'm not a part of the group, there might also be women in there, but as far as I know and from kind of the reports I've got, it's quite a derogatory group that men are sharing pictures of women in their scuba gear in. So, you know, going back to that kind of last, like, is it still safe to post pictures of yourself in scuba wear at the moment? Well, when groups like this exist, it's quite hard to really know the right thing to do. That Pinterest is full absolutely full of women, like fetish scuba gear. This one in particular I just thought was quite, to show you how kind of it's not even as obvious. So I love beautiful, sexy girls, women with oval masks. And of course, the only people that wear those oval masks are scuba divers, snorkelers, or free divers. So, you know, it's not just the wetsuits. It's also the kind of scuba equipment that's being sexualized. So even in 2020, women are still being sexualized in scuba diving, but we have to ask ourselves, now, are we kind of, because we are uploading the photos ourselves, do we need to be that little bit more careful about it? So again, I'm to make my research fair, I also wanted to see if there was a market for women who were looking for sexy men in scuba diving, or if women had fetishes of men in scuba dive gear. And it was a lot easier to find imagery from, you know, 2010 to 2020. And those are the images that you see now, more kind of like model shots, you know, it's almost like high fashion, or kind of things that may be used in like big department stores or something like that. But I didn't find any imagery of men being sexualized at all. Before around 2015. So that was quite interesting to know. So is scuba diving still a male sport? Well, I think it definitely comes down to opinion, but a lot of it comes down to facts, which is why I'm showing you the PADI trend by gender, which is their kind of statistics that they bring out every few years, which shows you how many men to women are being certified by them, so by their agency. So this is just PADI. So what you can see, we've only got up until 2018. So, you know, maybe something different will change in the next 2 years. But what you can see is obviously we're on all-time high in 2018 with 38% of females to 62% male certified divers. But if you look down to 2013, it's 34.4. So what they show is that it's been less than a 4% increase over the last 5 years. Of course, this is just PADI as one certifying agency. It would be amazing to know all of the agencies and to really understand and to grasp how many females are in diving at the moment. But that's not really a tool that has been available to us at the moment. But, you know, some people might find that it's not even needed, that we don't need to know if there is more women than men in the industry. So that's obviously, again, is kind of opinionated. So this is something else I wanted to show you, just to kind of like, this is almost like a rhetorical question. Is scuba diving still a male sport? That is definitely something that we all need to make our own opinion on, if you want to. But this is quite an interesting little clip. This was at the Go Diving Show, which was here in the UK in February. We had an amazing time, really, really great. And I got interviewed by somebody from Scuba Dive magazine, and they sent it to me yesterday, just, we finally finished it, and I looked for it. And one thing that actually came to my attention was the background and the people walking around in the background and just being like, okay, there's a lot of men. And if this one clip is just kind of a little overview of maybe the gender inequality of the dive industry at the moment, you know, maybe it is, maybe it's not, you could take a look. So quite interestingly, he's actually asked me a question about how I would like to change the industry.
Is what one thing would you change about diving to encourage more new people to take up the sport?
I would change that there are more female divers. There's a split of 70% to 30% male-female divers. We definitely need more girls in diving.
How would you do that?
We are doing it. We're encouraging girls by being positive role models, by showing them how fun it is, how exciting it is, and how they can get involved.
Good answer.
So as you can kind of see in the background, I think there was that one lady there, and there was a younger girl here, and the rest were kind of even older, a little bit maybe older than me, I'm 31, men. So if that was just kind of like a little screenshot of just to show just here and now, like how it still is, there's still is a lot of men in the industry. Is it still a man's world? Again, that's a very rhetorical question and opinionated question, which I definitely want to get you all involved with in a bit once I finish this. A lot of times when I talk about female divers, about changing the industry, about needing more female scuba divers, most people would agree, actually. I haven't come across too many people that are like, no, that's complete rubbish. But what they do want to know is like how they can actually help, whether you're even male or female, like how you can help make more of that kind of equality, more of an equal playing field with men and women. So I always like to kind of come up with like a few different reasons, solutions, and ways that we can all kind of help to encourage more women in scuba diving. So starting off with spreading positive imagery. And what I mean by that is embracing your body the way that you want to do that and to completely own that. And you can see here, this is our Girls at Scuba cover photo. And what we want to do is just keep changing those photos of all of our members and just kind of show that, you know, women come in all shapes and sizes. And if you want to share a picture of yourself in your bikini, that's absolutely fine. If you would rather share it in full dry suit with only your eyes showing or whatever, that's absolutely fine. But it's that positive imagery, it's that positivity that it kind of shows that we are owning being a female in the scuba dive industry. Encouraging your kids into diving, not just female. Little boys, little girls, encourage them into diving because they are our future. They really are the future of scuba diving. Scuba diving in general is a fairly older industry. I kind of saw a statistic just the other day that it's kind of like 1988, which is actually the year I was born, is kind of the youngest in the kind of pro industry that like if you own a company or a dive center or something like that. So it's 31. So we really need more younger people in scuba diving. Also, if you do work in media, any of those kind of media outlets, magazines or TV or film or anything like that, and if you are a male, is just getting your female co-workers involved just to ask for proof or reading or, you know, just to check the imagery. A man has never been a woman, so, you know, maybe he doesn't know if that is the right way to portray. Some of these images may have been portrayed wrong because the man wasn't actually understanding what it was that females didn't like about that image. Obviously, don't sexualize female divers. I can't stress enough how this is the most obvious thing, but we have to wear swimsuits, we have to wear wetsuits to be scuba divers because we're getting in the body of water. But that doesn't mean that because we're in swimwear or wetsuits that's automatically sexualized. These are our armor of what we are going scuba diving with. And this is what we need to be scuba divers. So it shouldn't be sexualized just because we're used to seeing swimwear models and stuff like underwear models kind of in the media again. And rise up other women. It's so important if you are a female to continue to raise up other females, celebrate their achievements, shout about what they're doing, and just really encourage them and be positive. Positivity really, really, really is something that can empower females. It's an amazing thing you can do. If you work in a scuba company, a dive center, anything like that, to make sure, take a look around you and hire an equal amount of men to women. So I've said this to quite a few people before and they've kind of come back with like, well, I actually can't even find females to come and work for me. Which could be the case. We actually have a Facebook group, which is female dive jobs, where you can, if you're a female, post in it. If you're a male, you can get one of your female colleagues, friends, partners, to post in it and actually say, you know, we are specifically looking for a female because we want to create more of an equal, you know, workplace. So yeah, and there's plenty of other Facebook groups as well for hiring jobs worldwide. I can tell you, we've got 45,000 women in our Facebook group, and I know a lot of them would love a job. So that's definitely not an excuse that you can't find any. Forget stereotypes, of course, like women can do anything that men can do. Men can do anything that women can do. Like, stereotype in scuba diving doesn't need to be a thing. Empower yourself and stand up for what you believe in is so important. And I believe in it a lot, that you stand your ground. And if you don't think what somebody is doing is right, then you can say. It's actually quite nerve-wracking for me to host a talk like this, because I'm opening myself up for criticism, and opening myself up for debate and conversation, because I'm talking about something that I'm so passionate about, but is also talking about sexualizing and my opinion. But I believe in it, and so I stand up for myself, and I do it, and I do it for all of us women, and I know that all of you men do it as well, but it's never lose your voice, you know, like, keep doing what you believe in. Be open to conversation that goes on with that, you know, regardless of your gender, be open to conversation about it. If it's something you don't believe, you don't think is happening in the industry, it's always nice to know why other people think it is happening or isn't. So open to conversation is always really, really good, to be open, like I've said that from the start of this. I just slipped in there that pink doesn't equal feminine, because also it's a whole new topic, but how the scuba dive industry makes female gear by putting a little bit of pink on it. We're way more versatile than that. We like other colours than pink, but that is a completely different subject. But there was one of the magazines which had a very positive imagery of a woman on it, but it had women in pink. So it's just kind of like these really small things, like, but they make a difference for us. And the last one is, feminism is not a bad word. I've been called a feminist all my life, and I'm proud. So actually, be a feminist means that you believe in gender equality, and there's absolutely nothing bad about that at all. So definitely don't be afraid of using that word. And now, just to kind of close it off, you know, I feel like women have it hard enough. They don't want to be worried about coming into an industry where they might maybe sexualized, where their photo might be taken and put into a group for men to look at. They don't want to be degraded or undermined by a man because somebody thinks that they can't do the same thing as them. So, you know, all the things we're trying to do at Girls of Scuba is obviously inspire, discuss, like, create an equal industry, encourage more divers, but to have fun. Scuba diving is fun, and we should be having so much fun, and we should be coming together as a community to enjoy the most beautiful, amazing thing that we all know, which is scuba diving. So I just wanted to show you a little video of our last Girls at Scuba Day, just to show you the impacts that we have had in bringing females together and making sure that people are having fun while scuba diving. So yeah, this is our Girls at Scuba Day that we had a few weeks before all this happened. We raised a ton for charity. It was all for charity. And we had 60 girls all diving at once. So enjoy this little video. So yeah, that was just a fun example of what we're doing at Girls at Scuba to bring women together and to hopefully change the next decade of scuba diving media and representation of females. And I'm so excited to be heading the world's largest female dive community and to have a voice and to have very strong passion and an influence to make a change in the industry with all of you women and men who are supporting our mission. So if you don't already, these are all the ways that you can follow us, Girls at Scuba. If you type Girls at Scuba in any of the social media handles, you find us. And if you are interested in following me personally, I'm at Coffee Than Travel. And then one quick plug, I also run a waste and plastic-free shop. And any help at this time would be amazing if you do fancy any plastic-free goodies. So you can head over to that. But that is it from me. I'm going to open it up to you guys and back to Jay if you've got any questions.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Sarah. That was amazing. Really great presentation. So guys, if anyone has any questions, what you can do is type them in the Q&A box at the bottom of your screen. Just click on it, type the messages in, and we'll read them out to Sarah and answer them and go from there. So let's see what we got. First one. Perfect. Steph says, thanks for the presentation. In some industries, such as science, there isn't much of a gender cap lower on the rung. But as they get more senior and specialized, more males progress than females. Does Patty report the numbers for the gender gap between professional divers at, say, a dive master and instructor level?
Not that I know of, but I have had conversations about this kind of gap and fall off of like women when they kind of develop into an, you know, difference between kind of school, university level up to a little bit older. And actually the reason that that happens is because women actually go off and have kids and have a family. And obviously we choose to do that and maybe put our career on side. And I'm pretty sure that's what happens in science as well. If you do choose to have a family, then obviously it's quite harder to get back into your work or your sport. And like it's so hard to kind of collect the data from that, but it's definitely something we've been seeing in Girls at Scuba as well. We started up Mums at Scuba to try and encourage kind of mums to get back into it, but again, like I crave these statistics, but certification agencies don't seem to really want to give them out. But I mean, maybe we can do something ourselves.
I think that's a really interesting question. I would honestly love to see that information. I'm curious if any of our contacts at Patty have that data to see whether there is like a massive fall off, like from, you know, one between moving into professional and then onward, or whether if there's anything like that, or even going from recreational into professional. Would be really interesting numbers to check out.
Any statistics would be interesting. Yeah, we don't get many diving.
That's a really good question, though. Really good. Thanks, Steph. So then Laurel asks, are the diving certification agencies doing anything to get more women certified?
I don't have like insider information on it or anything, but from what I can see, obviously, like Paddy do their Paddy's Women's Day, which they've been doing since, I think, 2017. Whether that's to get more females certified, I think it probably is. But I wouldn't say that any of the agencies are massively trying to get more women into it. I think they do also work with like bloggers, and they try to get female bloggers to kind of write about their experiences as female divers, but I can't say I've seen too much of a push other than Paddy's Women's Day. But you know, one day to encourage women, is it enough? No. So I don't know. I mean, does anyone else know of anything?
I don't know. I mean, that's all. Like I was gonna say, that the only one I really know from Patty is the Women's Day. I knew that there's a good amount, a decent amount of women ambassador divers through Patty and all that kind of stuff. I think I was looking at it, it's almost like 50-50 or more or something like that. But there's not anything that I've seen that are, say, a specific pull to try and get more women into diving and these kind of things.
No, and the thing I worry about with those kind of things, with the ambassador divers and stuff like that, is like, are they doing it to kind of to show equality, or are like, is it really to encourage more? Like, it's very hard to know, whether it's a marketing technique. or, you know, just a way to kind of like build a quality within their brand.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. That's a be curious, another one, and love to find the answers too.
Yeah.
Perfect. So Juleha says, thank you. You're right. You're brave. Thank you again. Then Anonymous says, just a note, remember to include consideration of the transgender community. I understand that trends may be easier when side gender is the focus, but where many are more fluid than that in the real world. Just a simple statement around that would be nice.
Absolutely. And we do, Girls at Scuba, we actually, members have to answer 3 questions to enter into the Girls at Scuba group, the private group. And our first question is, do you identify as a woman? So we actually changed that wording as somebody actually did come to us and talk about transgender and kind of explained a little bit more. So we changed the wording for that. So we do allow people in that do identify as being women. But again, it's something that we're in such a small kind of niche of an industry, even being a female diver. And it's like, we need to get even closer into those nitty gritty of more of the niches as well. And the great thing is that we're only 3 years old, and if we're anything like people in the dive industry and we're here for the, like, hopefully we're here forever, then, you know, we have time and you guys can come to me and you can actually suggest things.
That's awesome. Shannon says, no question, but I'm a GTS member and I wanted to say thank you for such a wonderful group and a safe space.
Oh, thank you so much. That means so much.
That's awesome. Steven asks, do manufacturers cater for women other than just making things pink?
Yes, they do. Definitely. They do now, for sure. There's been loads of developments, even in the last 5 years, I would say. There's been lots of developments. Wetsuits in particular, I would say. They are kind of, you know, bringing out wetsuits, which are more designed for females. But I would also still say that custom wetsuits are probably the way forward with that, because you, even when you do design a wetsuit for females, like, you can't possibly get every single female and male, any person, you know, into 7 sizes. But yeah, some brands are doing very, very good jobs of that. Same as BCDs. A lot of BCDs with females maybe cut us under the breast. So what some brands have been doing is kind of like lowering the BCDs and, of course, like taking out the pockets and stuff like that, even developing the wings. So there is lots of development in there. And I do actually communicate with brands quite a lot. And anything we get through Girls at Scuba, you know, I will go back to them and say, you know, like, had a bit of a negative comment in Girls at Scuba about how you're not developing your line. And, you know, they always have got something happening. There is just, it's, from what it seems, it's not as easy to just to develop something overnight, but they have been trying for the last few years. However, I would say it's still not up to scratch. And we did do a poll in Girls at Scuba to ask if women felt like there was more male gear to female, and 70% said that they felt like it was an advantage to male gear. So there definitely is not enough development, but people are doing it.
Yeah, a lot more to be still done.
Yeah.
Then Coral asks, there was a Reddit post that mentioned women getting more help with their gear. What's your take on this? Will accepting help mean that we are weaker or not as good as male divers?
Yeah, that Reddit post that we put up. No, it doesn't mean you're weaker. It doesn't mean you're stronger either. I mean, it doesn't, it's completely up to you. Like, if you want someone to help with your gear, it'd be the same if I said, hey, Jay, do you want me to grab your camera? Or do you want me to grab your tank? Like, if you needed me to, you would say yes, and so would I. It doesn't, I don't know where this kind of came from, that if men help women, it means they're not strong. That's not true. Like, somebody might need help. You also have to take in disability as well. Like, someone, a male or a female, may not be able to carry their own gear. And this kind of stereotype that you're not strong enough to carry your gear really needs to go, because there's so many factors in that, in carrying your gear. And it doesn't make you stronger. It doesn't make you less strong if you can or you can't.
Yeah, exactly. All right. So Anonymous asks, thank you for this. Do you have any information or metrics on how women of color are represented in the dive community, or whether there is any representation of women of color in dive media?
Nope. Again, we have absolutely nothing. We have had kind of, we always have conversations, and we have done for the last few years that Girls at Scuba has come about. Somebody actually suggested that we started like Black Girls at Scuba or something along that. But we said no, because like this is just females. And like we said before, it's if you identify as a female, then you're part of Girls at Scuba. And, you know, we don't want to be segregating. But like, we've never had any information or any statistics again about women of color. And I would love to be able to kind of get more involved in that. But yeah, I'm very, very aware. I don't want anyone to think that in Girls at Scuba that we're not sharing enough photos of women of color. Like, we try to find as many as we can. We want to represent women in color. And I'm very aware that we're not doing the best job that we can. So I'm so open to anyone that wants to come and talk about that.
Awesome. So then that's it. Cassandra asks, how do you think the scuba diving industry would have developed differently if historically it had been a female dominated industry instead of a male dominated industry? How would it look different today if for the last century divers had been, say, 70% or more female?
Wow, it's an amazing question. I've never thought about that. I feel like we're always so good at kind of like dealing with what we've got and, you know, trying to show our power. But like, what if, huh? What if? Oh, I don't know. It's so hard to say what would have happened. The feminist and the, you know, the passion inside of me that wants women to be the best they possibly can would like to think that it would be, you know, a very positive image, a very positive industry, and you know, one of maybe less stereotypes, but who knows.
Question
I'm gonna think about.
So let's see. Anonymous says, thanks Sarah for your amazing work at GTS and Waste Free World. You're truly an inspiration. I bought all my dive gear actually based on your recommendation, so thank you for sharing those few family female friendly gear brands. But no question, eh? Just
awesome. Yeah, that's super cool. I think that's a really great thing about Girls at Scuba, like you can find so many recommendations, like, and not ones that are just like the brands think we should talk about. It's like actual reviews from actual women.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. It was also just a note, Laura has mentioned that she says, I've been certified since 1981, and though I understand why you want to track a younger generation to diving, don't forget the older folks. I'm also a member of GTS. But she also then said, there's a National Association of Black Scuba Divers. I can paste the link out to everybody for the anonymous person that asked the original one.
Yes.
Throw that in the chat so everyone's got it.
Amazing.
Thank you, Laura. Thanks for that information.
Yes, thank you so much.
Awesome. So then let's go another anonymous question. Got lots of anonymous questions today. I often am one of very few females at the dive shop that I dive. The men treat the guys as tough and women as fragile, limiting us to of exciting possibilities that it seems they think we can't handle. This I could relate to that comment posted on your slide. It repels a lot of the girls from the club, and me saying something about it makes it seem like I'm just whining. How do you approach situations like this, keeping a good relationship with the club whilst getting them to treat everyone more equally?
Yeah, it's a very, very good point. And it goes to kind of what I said about how, like, it makes me nervous talking about things like this, and it shouldn't. Like, that just shows that, like, there's so many women that are nervous to, like, even that we, like, don't even want to say our names, like, in the comments and stuff. Like, we're scared because we're scared to come off of, like, confrontation or, like, that we feel so, you know, we feel vulnerable. And I think it's such a good point that it's actually quite hard. Like, there's one thing me being like, girl power, stand up for yourself, but like, how do you actually do that? And it can be very intimidating. You know, I'm very, very hard to do, and it definitely depends on your personality as well. Some people might feel more comfortable. I would say, like, definitely a great resource is obviously the Girls at Scuba group, where you can really reach out for help and ask thousands and thousands of women of how to deal with that. And it, again, it's such a hard situation. It's always different, you know. You kind of, I would say, maybe make it in a group, maybe kind of not so much confront, but just kind of talk about, like, oh, that made me feel a little bit uneasy, or yeah, like that didn't make me feel great. Like, what was that comment about? And just kind of like make sure other people are hearing. Like, I always, again, like when men ask me how they can help, like there's so many supportive men in scuba. And when they say, look, how can we help? And I always say, like, stand up for a woman if she says something. If she has the confidence and, you know, she's gone out and said, you've made me feel uncomfortable, and you hear it, like, stand up for her and be like, yeah, that wasn't really a nice thing to say. So we have to surround ourselves with positive men as well as females. But check out Girls at Scuba and just kind of ask the women inside of that. But I understand it's hard and there's not really an answer that I can, like, straight up answer I can give. I would be scared too.
Great, Anton. Thank you for that, Sarah. So one more question. They ask, how do you involve men in supporting this?
Wow, my good friend over here, Jay Clue. Many of you probably don't know, but we're actually really, really good mates. We've been friends for years, and Jay, I come over to Cabo, Mexico, Girls at Scuba Do, and Jay helps us run our Girls at Scuba Day because he's the man in the know in Cabo. And when I first came, I didn't know anything about it. And he actually was like, you know, I know loads of girls that would love to come to a Girls at Scuba Day. And, you know, he's been helping me host the day in Cabo. And so something like that, like for men that can reach out and just be like, hey, like, how can I help? Let's do a female dive. Let's do a female, like, social, anything like that. Like, there are so many supportive men in scuba diving, and I'm very, very lucky to know a lot of them. And I make sure I only surround myself in, you know, the positive people. But, you know, men can have, like, men also shouldn't be afraid, like, of reaching out to women. And, you know, even it's like, oh yeah, Sarah Richard, like, the founder of Girls at Scuba, like, massive feminist, so you can still come to me and ask me, because that's what we want. You know, we want men to be reaching out and saying, like, you're right, we need more women, like, cut the bullshit, like, we don't want to know about, like, how 10 years ago this happened. You know, I've got an idea, why don't we do a Girls at Scuba Day, why don't we do a female day, why don't we promote, like, one of our female staff members on social media and stuff like that.
That's awesome. I mean, it's been great with us. We get questions about it sometimes from different guests that come in and all these kind of things, and they ask it. I mean, most people, I guess a lot of people don't realize too, most of Dive Ninjas is actually female, like most of our staff.
Yeah. Just you.
Yeah, it's just me and actually, well, and Kenzo now is newest team member. But the majority of the team is all female, and it's not that, you know, not that we specifically went this way, it's just they were the best people for the job when we were hiring for these specific positions, and, you know, they beat out everyone else that was there. And, you know, I love our team, they're like family to us, but we get a lot of questions about it and everything like that too, and it's, you know, we just mm-hmm. try to look at everything as equal. We don't see it at Diamond as male or female. We just actually, there was an article written, just went out on our website the other, about a couple days ago, from one of our customers, Sue. She wrote an article about her trials and tribulations of trying to get into technical diving. And she's a, you know, very advanced diver. She's been diving for years and has more dives than some instructors I know under her belt and everything, but she just dives recreational and was trying to get into the technical side of things, had a lot of different tribulations and trials and all that. But yeah, I can put the post in the chat if anyone would be interested in reading that or anything.
Yeah, like, and it's a very interesting article because it spoke about not just being a female, but being like small female, and how she was like worried that men would look like, oh, what's this, you know, kind of small girl coming into tech diving for? And also about, like, would the equipment be too heavy? Because it's a fair enough question, like, if you are small, and, or it doesn't matter what size you are, like, people, it's side mount, you got two tanks all of a sudden, you want to know if it's heavy, and, you know, shouldn't be put down for asking those questions. It is a very good article.
I'm just gonna post, give me a second, I'll post it in here. There we go. I just sent it in the chat if anyone wants to check it out. The link's in there, or feel free to hit up the Dive Ninjas website to check it out. Awesome. So we got one more question from Amber. She says, for Patty Women's Dive Day last year, their Instagram account depicted a very stereotyped image of a female diver. I was personally disappointed in them as an organization, as there's so much more to women in the dive community. I would have personally preferred to see a tech diver or a scientist. What's your take on Patty's photo choice for 2019?
I get asked this a lot, actually. I agree with you, Amber. I think that you're right. And, you know, it kind of still goes along those lines. of what we looked at earlier in the presentation, that where like women started to get sexualized in scuba diving was that very, very small petite girl with big boobs and usually like blonde hair. And then it's, we've stepped away from it, but we still have a stereotype of a female scuba diver who is trim, who looks good in a bikini and has a nice face. And that's kind of like the social media side of, which is another conversation, social media side of kind of like of female scuba divers. And I agree, and we're not affiliated with Paddy, so actually I don't even really know anyone that works in Paddy. I'm not sure of their social media team or anything like that, but some of these companies actually, they have like social media teams that actually aren't really so much related to the organization, and maybe just have like you know, kind of like set schedule of what they need to do, and they're just trying to find like that viral like photo that will get them the most likes, because they think getting the most likes and getting the most followers is the right thing to do. And I think that we struggled with that, girls at scuba as well, when we were first starting. It was, you know, learning to step away from just like the pretty picture and what looks good, to actually showcasing more of what females actually look like, and trying to represent, you know, everybody. Yeah, I guess that's maybe something that Paddy struggled with. But they know girls at scuba, they know where we're at. They could ask.
Awesome. I think the last question we got, if no one has any other questions today, we can say thank you for stopping by so much. It's great to see you as always. Hope to see you in Mexico soon.
Yes. Thank you so much. Anyone can obviously reach us at Girls at Scuba or message me if they have any questions other than this.
Awesome. Well, thank you everyone for tuning in today and for this great chat. We'll be back on Monday at our normal time at 10 a.m. Pacific with Maxwell Hahn, who's a National Geographic and BBC videographer, taking us kind of off the grid to go see what it's like diving in strange rivers and ponds and all these kind of things out in the British Columbia wild. So looking forward to that. So everyone have a great weekend. If you're celebrating Easter holiday, happy Easter, and have enjoyed the time at home and all that. Have some fun. Maybe go find some Easter eggs and all that good stuff. So have a great weekend, everyone. We'll see you soon. Thanks again, Sarah, for coming in, for stopping by.